Hey guys, welcome back to another video. In this one, if I sound a little weird or if there's a lot of like cuts, that is because I'm feeling a little bit under the weather. No, it is not COVID. I came down with a little bit of a cold, just like a day thing, and I'm already getting better, but like my voice sounds a little funny. Might be sniffling, might be coughing. Hopefully I'll be able to cut all that out. So for today's video, I asked you guys on Instagram to let me give you some advice for free. So I'm going to be going through some of your asks and answering them. They are all going to be anonymous, and I'm going to try to give you the best advice I can. I'm not great at all things, and I love giving advice, but ultimately I am one person. You should ask multiple people, in my opinion, for advice on a subject to get different points of view before you make your decisions. So yeah, let's get into it. The first ask I'm going to be answering is, I used to love to draw and be creative when I was younger. How can I rekindle that flame? I recently just went through something similar. I do a lot of art stuff for school, so I was feeling really zapped pre-COVID, pre-quarantine. And a big part of lockdown for me was rekindling my creative flame for drawing and just creating any kind of content in general. One of the ways I did this is I went back to some of my old drawings and stuff, and I recreated them now with the skills I have now. This not only showed my growth in my skills, but it also kind of just was an easy way for me to get back in the habit of drawing. It's, you know, an easy entrance because a lot of times it's like, well, what should I draw? Like, you know, it's the inspiration that is hard to find when you're trying to get back into something like that, not necessarily the drive or the want. It's just kind of like art block, like you just don't know how to get started. So I would definitely go back to those pieces that you did when you were younger and redo them and see how your skills have maybe improved, and from there you can see where you want to improve more. And you know, doing these things will help you gain inspiration into making new works of art. The next person asked, how can I improve my emo style? For me, this is a general question. I know you specified like emo, but this can really apply to any sort of fashion or personal style, really any kind, is that you have to make it your own. And I know that sounds really vague and like not helpful at all, because like, what does that mean, make it your own? But the point is that you can follow all the WikiHow tutorials, you can put all the Pinterest outfit boards together, you can recreate all the emo outfits you see on Instagram, but ultimately it's never going to feel right, or you're never going to be fully confident in those looks until it is something that, you know, you feel is your own. For me, a lot of that is I like to mix styles. I like to pull from a variety of different interests and looks. I do it based on my comfort level. So there are times when I'm super comfortable wearing like skirts and frills, and so I wear that. And then there are certain times when I'm not, so I don't wear that. It's kind of feeling out yourself and your own interests. I guess a good test of this is to put together something really basic, really generic, lay it all out, and then kind of think, what do I bring to the table? What are things about me that I can put into this outfit? So for me, a lot of that is accessories. So bracelets, chokers, I wear a lot of jewelry that I make of my own. It just adds uniqueness to your outfit, and it adds like something that you're not gonna find anywhere else. Like, yeah, I'm sure you see a lot of people who wear bracelets, but not these ones, because these are the ones that I made, you know? Stuff like that. And even if it isn't something that you make, it's just like an extra touch that you add to an outfit that's like, you didn't just see that on Pinterest and go, oh, gonna do that. It's something that you added yourself. I think that's a big factor into being comfortable, and when you are comfortable in your style, you have confidence, and when you have confidence, anything looks good. The next person asked me, how do I make friends in a new atmosphere? I am starting college really soon and I'm very nervous. I completely understand this one, and I don't 100% have super good advice, because I'm terrible at making friends, like absolutely awful at making friends. Up until I'd say maybe a year ago, I hadn't made any new friends post high school, like it's my freshman year of high school. So it is very like hard for me to give advice, but I can think back to things that I wish I had done starting college and kind of go from there. So I'd say definitely get involved. Most colleges, when the semester starts, they have a like involvement fair where you can see all the different clubs, all the different activities going on campus. Check those out. Maybe you'll find one that is interesting to you. You can join it and you can meet people that way really, really easily. Another thing is the people in your classes are gonna maybe like some of your easiest ways to make friends. College is very different from high school in the fact that not everybody's taking the same classes all the time. So like in high school, you all have to take chemistry, no matter what period it's in, no matter what time you take it at. But in high school, the people in your classes are going to be very unique because not everyone is taking the same classes with the same professors. So reach out to those people, definitely, especially if it's a class that you have to struggle in. Ask for help, you know, stuff like that. A lot of classes have study groups. Attend those. That's another way to make friends. And like when you get further into college or depending on what you're studying, it's easy to make friends more concentrated within your like major or course of study. For me, that's where I end up making my friends is in the theater department. Got to put my phone on silent. I ended up making a lot of friends through, you know, the theater department. It's a very small group. So I had a lot of the same people in my classes. I would say a lot of the same people in the theater spaces. So I ended up making a lot of friends that way, just being around the same people all the time, which comes with working in your specified programs. But yeah, those are definitely some ways that I would say to reach out and make friends that are very low stress, because I know for me it's very hard to go out of my way to talk to people. So things like clubs where you're in close contact with people and you're like relied to work with other people, that's a good icebreaker. You know, classes, you sit next to somebody on the first day, go ahead and say hi. It's really something simple like that. A lot of classes require you to break into groups. Don't be afraid of that. Just kind of dive head first, which is really nerve-wracking. But like when you're in groups, you learn to talk to people. And a lot of the times when I had classes that made me break into groups, we didn't talk about the things we were supposed to be talking about anyways. We just talked about whatever. And definitely reach out to the people in your major. This is especially helpful because, you know, these are the people who are studying the same things as you, have the same career goals as you. You're gonna have a lot of common right off the bat. And the last ask for advice I have says, how do I tell a friend I like them? Now, this is something I am not particularly keen on, considering I've been in a relationship forever, like 8 years forever. So I never really had that situation of having to deal with pursuing a actual relationship with somebody other than my significant other. But my best advice would to be just to rip the bandaid off and do it. I know that with a friend, it's a lot more difficult than like just somebody you're acquaintances with because, you know, you don't want to risk the friendship. You don't want things to be awkward. But in my experience with watching friends go through this, it generally makes the relationship awkward anyways, because you know you have this thing you're holding on to that you don't want them to know, or you want them to freak out, you don't know how they're gonna feel, and so it kind of eats away at you and you kind of pull away from the friendship and things like that happen. So I just think it's best if you have a talk, just a good old-fashioned sit-down communication talk. Just say, hey, look, I don't know how you feel about this. I know it's weird, but like I got feelings for you. And you know, whether they have feelings too or they don't, you at least had that talk and you can come to a conclusion, I guess. Whether it's that you guys stay friends, you know, you try something more than friends, or maybe they both have feelings for each other and it's just like, wow, didn't know. Ultimately, it will like take a toll on the friendship. It will make things awkward for a while. But if you guys are like true friends, it shouldn't be a big deal. Like, I cannot tell you the amount of times I've had crushes on friends of mine. It happens, especially when you're spending so much time with somebody or you're really close with somebody. It's really easy to develop feelings, and I feel like if you're both relatively mature adults, that should just kind of be understood that, like, I mean, maybe we try it, maybe it doesn't work out, we could just stay friends. Or, I don't feel that way about you, let's just stay friends. And like, yeah, it's gonna be a little awkward for a while. But ultimately, I think that if your friendship is like strong, you guys will be okay either way. Well, that's all the advice I have to give out today. If you guys enjoyed this video, please let me know. Leave a comment, like the video. Definitely subscribe if you haven't. Don't know why you wouldn't want to see more of me giving probably terrible advice, but I'll do more of this if you guys want it. With all that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you in the next one.